Ah, here they are.
Hey, I'm so glad you came. So, I presume you've read some of the bad press we are getting, or heard the news.
Yes, it's a real problem, and we've got the best security in the city.
Which is why it's a setup.
Indeed, it's a setup, madam. My team and I are doing our best, but we have to be vigilant. You don't want any problematic negativity. George, eyes left. Watch that guy.
No, we don't. Not anymore. We cannot afford any additional lawsuits.
Well, our acquaintances here look innocuous enough. And from what I understand, they can handle themselves. So how about we take a little tour and deal with any miscreants?
Miscreant. Interesting word.
Very.
What would you like me to call the assholes the Duggins pay to start fights?
Whatever you like. But stop them as soon as you can. And next time, how about not letting them in?
My friends, shall we perambulate around the campus?
Before you go, anyone for a little champagne?
God, give me strength.
Follow me. You know what's happening, right? The Duggins are paying people to start fights. Been happening all week, and social media is starting to take notice. Looks clear over here. Let's head over to the main floor. Disorderly conduct blemishes our reputation, and we pride ourselves on our reputation, and it could put us out of business entirely. Those are the hillbillies on the Douglas payroll. Calm them down. Stop this trouble.
Fucking cheat! What the fuck? Ah! Oh, fuck!
What an unfortunate business. Thank you. Thank you for your help.
Well done.
I think we managed to quell the importunate uprising, madam.
Well done, Vincent. Any ideas?
I imagine it was someone who wishes to besmirch the good name of this institution.
We know that.
Sorry to interrupt here. Brucey Kibbutz. Can we talk about health and wellness for a second here?
Excuse me?
Brucey Kibbutz, I want to talk to you about the mindfulness and exercise director's position.
Not right now. I'm kind of busy.
Oh, you're too busy to discuss health and well-being?
Call guest services, sir. Make an appointment.
Very amusing. Do I look like I make appointments, bro? I am the appointment!
Anyway, thank you. Again, I hope I don't have to ask for your further assistance, but I fear I shall.
Yes, this will do very nicely. Very nice place you've got. Very chic. Nothing like a bourgeois bank robber to remind me of how strange. There's a Fleece of franchise on the Western Highway near Chumash. Take us there. Word of warning, we're on the job right now, so don't let the cops notice you. If they come after us, we call it off. So, my taciturn friends, I suppose you want to know how we're doing this. Well, funny you should ask. We're driving out to the bank, taking a look at it, picking up some equipment, and then heading back to make our plans. Not very complex at all. We're not going in, we're not poking it with a stick. We're just sitting back and taking a look. You see, I like my scores, I like my dates. Across the street and unaware they're being watched. All right, so why this bank over all the other banks in the state? Why does fortune favor this one? Another good question. You're full of good questions. You're like a child whose parents think it's clever, or the IRS. Well, this bank's got some safety deposit boxes. And in one of those safety deposit boxes are some bonds being hidden from the tax man that no one's gonna report missing. All starting to make sense. Security should be light. Well, relatively light. Light if your daydreams are raids on the Union Depository. Quite heavy if your day job is turning over liquor stores and gas stations. And the bonds in the box will be worth more than a few rumpled notes from a till, so the minor escalation is worth it. If you can handle it. Plus, you know, the sea view. Nothing like staring at the ocean while you contemplate money and power, incarceration and homicide. Yeah, all those weighty issues surrounding your first foray into serious armed robbery. I'm assuming you're kind of a cerebral crew, because otherwise this whole not-talking deal just kind of puts you on the spectrum, right? Okay, well, how about we just get there and see where we're at? There it is. Take a look. Drink it in. I've patched into their security feed on my cell. Take a look. What are we looking at? Small joint. Not much security. Staff won't give a crap, especially about the deposit boxes. Customers will probably be thinking how to turn this into a screenplay. The boxes are in the back behind a safe door. We want box number 167. Yeah, it's right on the highway with good access. That works for you. You can get out quick, but it'll also work for the cops. Speed up their response time. Okay? Okay. Enough of this peeper crap. Let's go to the garment factory. Now, when you hit the bank, you're gonna need to hack into its security system. I've written a neat little program that'll do most of the work for you, but it's probably a good idea for you to familiarize yourselves with it. You, in the passenger seat, I've sent it to your phone. You take it for a dry run, keep your hands steady, and maybe the wet run won't be a disaster. My assistant. First she's gonna get us what we need, then she's gonna saw me in half. No? Like that one? You don't make it easy. Paige, it's Lester. The place looked good. Nothing we weren't expecting. Can you get the intel together? Hard copies to go on a notice board. Yeah, plus all the equipment we spoke about. I'll be over to collect it with, those people. Yeah. Charming as ever. Okay, see you soon. She's loading the hardware into the back of a truck. Tools for the job, things for you to wear. On a job, your attire will depend on the role you're performing. As the job gets more complicated, so will the uniforms. If you're likely to be seen by civilians, you'll be provided with a couple of masks. Then, when you go into the bank, you can choose one that, goes with your eyes. And hey, there's the added bonus of none of your favorite comic convention outfits being linked to a major crime. Whoop-dee-doo. All right, where were we? Masks. Paige. Oh, yeah. We'll go over there, pick her up, and go back to your place to plan this thing. I can talk you through the planning board later. That might be helped by a visual aid. The rest is pretty self-explanatory. Listen to me. Do what I say. Bullets go in here, come out there. And if you're ever caught, you keep your mouth shut. I couldn't resist. Hey, passenger seat. Did you get into their network? Good work. There's Paige. We're leaving this car, taking the truck. I should be using my cane.
Nice to meet you.
Now it's back to the apartment. Is it all there?
I think so. You want to get out and check? Go down the inventory? Or are you happy sitting there making a perfect butt imprint in your easy wipe seat?
I'll take your word for it.
Thank you. It should all be there. The clothes, guns, headsets, holdalls, masks, the drill, the files with all the photos and surveillance work. Hey, there's enough here to make us all look real suspicious. Nice little conspiracy to commit robbery charge waiting to happen.
What, they're gonna charge us with thought crime?
Not so much thought as everything but the deed crime. We'd be caught with our pants down and a hard-on out to here.
Well, we're not getting caught. These are professionals.
So I hear. The cheapest professionals money can buy.
I like to think of it as investing in new talent. And until you and me start playing low-rent Bonnie and Clyde, that's the way it's gotta be. She didn't mean anything by that, by the way. She's just a little brusque.
If they were offended, they would have said something.
I know. But fuck it, right?
Real and just...
not cool.
Hey, talk you through all these jobs. What do we got here? The car. Okay. You're on the way to Telpero. A Koreatown stick-up crew's been using a parking lot as a base for scores. They're into extortion, credit fraud, stolen cars, and some, mini-major robberies. I'd expect them to be packing, and I'd expect them to be paranoid. Come to think of it, you won't find a bulletproof car in the hands of anyone who doesn't have a healthy dose of paranoia. So be careful.
Performance. This is the one for us. Now, get in.
by your place when you're ready to go.
Ah, your first time. You know, the first times, well, it's never easy. There won't exactly be a...
It's not, is it? I should have been a dead. something with your tongue. Not that you use your tongue. The next pair of mutes I try to help into a career of crime, I'll make sure I threaten. So, since we're actually doing this, I'm gonna talk you through it one last time. We've given you pump-action shotguns to take in. They should look intimidating enough. You both go in. You go in hard. There are four security cameras in the foyer. Driver, take them out as soon as you walk in the door. Then you're on crowd control. Driller, when you're in the network, you'll be able to open the vault door on your phone. Go back to the safety deposit room and start drilling. Get the box, come out of there, get in the car, and hit the road. And part of the money I put up for this job went to getting you out clean. I hired the best guy in the business to get you away from the cops. He wasn't cheap, nor were the expenses he submitted. But, you know, only the best. When you're out of the bank, all you gotta do is get to him and he'll get you out. You think you can manage that? Well, we're all about to find out.
Don't shoot me.
Crap!
Someone help us!
You don't have to shoot me.
This would be the worst way to die.
Oh, crap! Oh, crap!
Tell me what to do. Don't shoot me.
Hey, I'm
Fox. Be ready to move.
I do not like this.
Damn.
Motherfucker.
Total retard.
Hey, help.
His name's Eddie Toe. He's a professional. He'll take care of everything.
Show it to me. Yes, it is the holiday season at the Crest residence, and Daddy's out drinking. Say, past. And if that thing I talked about comes up, I'll call you in. In the meantime, if anyone comes to me, I'll mention you as a reliable pair of hands. Hey! For the first time, that wasn't bad, but don't get clingy.
Going on?
Okay, I'll get you out of trouble. No problem.
Oh, it's the boss. Okay, here's our new vehicle warehouse. Let me show you around. We're gonna store all our vehicle cargo here before selling it. We can fit 40 cars in here. We got a vending machine and some personal space back there for getting some shut-eye and changing your clothes. When you bring a car back, it'll get fixed up and listed on Ad Hoc's Autos. When you access the website from the laptop on the desk, you'll see your current stock of cars and be able to select how many you want to offload and to who. The amount you can sell at any one time is dependent on how many associates you got on hand. If we want to chase the bigger commissions, we're going to need to modify the cars to the bigger buyer specifications. Remove trackers, change paint jobs, rims, apply other mods. Different buyers got different requirements. The mechanic's on site to handle all that. It's an independent operator, so it costs to repair stolen cars that come in damaged, and to do the mods. But believe me, it makes life easy. And you see the door over there? That'll take you all the way down to the underground facility. You renovated down there, so there's somewhere to store any of those big, unwieldy, modified vehicles off the Warstock site. Only place to accommodate anything from a huge Phantom Wedge to an amphibious Blazer Aqua. And that's it. We should get to work. The more vehicle cargo we move, the more of an interest SecuroServe's gonna take in the company. We steal enough cars, they'll throw us some special vehicle work. Come by the office when you want to source that next car. See you, boss.
Okay, boss, you want to sell something? You're in the right place. We log everything that comes in on the site, so you can see what we got in the warehouse. Select a vehicle, and it goes up on the export list at the top of the page. You can sell up to 4 vehicles at a time if you've got the drivers here in the warehouse. When the cars you want to sell are selected, confirm, and the system will search available buyers. There you go, we got 3 buyers. Pick who you like, but you should know that the bigger deal's got strings attached. They're gonna want you to do modifications up front. If you damage the car or lose it on the way to the sale, the money's gone. I'll do the modifications in-house, charge you a flat fee. It makes life simple for you and hard for me, but what else would you expect, right, boss? Make a call and we'll get on with it.
This should be a walk in the park, people. We take the car to the sale, we wait for our payment.
Oh!
This is huge. We got a sale. Great job out there.